What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. I'm about to take you on a service call for annual steam boiler maintenance. Here's the catch. We haven't been there since 2009 when we installed it, and it hasn't been serviced since then either.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you doing?
I'm good. Right. Here for some boiler service?
Yes, please. So we're going to turn it on. You can turn it on in, like, you know, the end of October.
Okay.
So.
Is there a light in there?
I'm looking for it right now. Like, I'm hardly ever in here. Where's the button? Okay, it's doing something. There we go.
Excellent. All right. There'd be light and there was light.
And there was light, yes. So, I mean, you guys installed it maybe 4 or 5 years, maybe 4 years ago. So I turned it on.
Okay.
Yeah, your name is on the little thing.
Yeah, no, I hear it. Actually, a lot more than 4 years, though.
You think so?
Yeah. Curious.
Okay.
We haven't installed an IN series in
quite
a while.
Some time.
Yeah, because they got replaced by a newer model. I'm not saying there's nothing wrong with your system, though, but time does get past us.
Time
does fly.
Listen,
has it been working fine over the time? When's the last time we serviced?
That's a great question. So that's why we called you. I couldn't even tell you. I think you guys put it in, and I think I tried to make an appointment last year, but you have a lot going on. So I didn't try again.
Now
this is just, yeah. We're going to try.
So we installed this boiler.
Yes. When did you install the boiler?
Well, you already guessed, 4 years. So the boiler was installed on the 13th of September in the year 2016.
Okay, well, that's more than 4 years.
Uh-huh. Okay,
yeah.
almost a decade, but
yeah.
9 years, a little over 9 years ago. Okay, very good. So no service in 9 years?
No, there has to be service in 9 years. I'm not
okay.
Sure. Yeah, but it would be you guys. So if you don't see anything,
no, there's nothing in there since they. You know, we here in March of 2016 to try to get the boiler up and running,
mm-hmm.
and then we came here in September to pick up a deposit, and then we installed it about a week later. Installed. We haven't been here since.
Well, then, yeah, no, because we were talking to you guys.
Then I would recommend we do a full service on this.
Okay.
It's gonna take about an hour, hour and a half.
Okay.
It is rough. Yeah, this boiler was manufactured in May of 2016.
I know. I turned it off. You said that it was manufactured in 2016. Well, then that's why you're like, I don't think.
Let's bypass the thermostat and see what happens here.
So he's gonna do a full cleaning, Daddy. It's been since 2016.
All right. So the thermostat upstairs is either not on or there's a problem with the signal from upstairs. Because I just bypassed the thermostat going upstairs and the wiring, and the boiler turned on. So let's go see the thermostat. So
does it, just need a
battery? It is set to 90. Mm-hmm. How old are these batteries?
I don't know. They're rechargeable. I changed them recently. Should I change them again?
Probably a good idea to replace them. There's a little bit of a delay there. You have two new AA batteries?
Yes, I do.
Hey. Hi. Here, take these two batteries. And they're recharged.
Charge.
You charge those up, and if not, maybe there's something wrong with the thermostat, but we will see.
Okay,
here.
You're welcome.
Charge. All right, heat. And just as a reminder of worthless information, the setting the temperature to a higher temperature mm-hmm. is not like a gas pedal in the car. It's either on or off.
Okay.
All right, so we are running. Problem with the thermostat battery. We changed the batteries. Let's keep that off. We have an automatic feeder here. We've got general just oxidization and rust on just a few components. Equalizer. There's our Hartford loop T.
There's a zone of the bottom of the boiler. Here's that zone relay for that zone at the bottom of the boiler and the low water cutoff. Pressure troll set where exactly where I left it. They must have missed the plate here, and that's why that's installed like that. But we installed this in September of 2016. Over 9 years since we've been here. Good rule of thumb, change the batteries in your thermostat before the heating season. All right, I like to lube everything up with WD-40 and then wipe it all with a well-oiled rag. Start it from the top. Plus, it makes it look nice and new and shiny, which I like. Beautiful. All right, once everything is wiped down, we'll start with the burners. Oh, man. That is in there pretty tight. Wow. It ain't coming out. All right, so that shipping screw, it ain't coming out. Don't worry, we'll get her out. Getting out of there. Oh man, it's real stubborn. Yeah, because it's been many years since it's been serviced and the screw doesn't want to come out. Now gone. Thank you.
double zip tie. The harness disconnects from the thermostat relay, and so no heat call. Now it's zip tied in place. Beautiful. Drain is right here. I've seen better days. Water level is slowly going down. Let's make sure the low water cutoff light illuminates when there's a low water condition. I don't want it to get too hot right now. Let's turn that to off. Oh, I didn't want that to happen. Still no light, the water level's all the way down there. I gotta take the probe out. Green, red, white. Let's take this out of there. Green, red, white. Take this dead boy out of there as well. Let's take the probe wire off. Quarter inch drive. And I will admit, I installed it wrong. The Teflon tape. Filthy. No Teflon tape on the threads. Pipe dope only. Come on, there you go. All right, let's tighten this up, reconnect. Oh, I should dump this out. Plug this in, We should not see no lights. Okay. Let's make sure those stay the way they are. Automatic water feeter. This is a WFE24. That's a PSC 80224. No, sorry, Cycle Guard CG400. SR501 single zone switching relay. Sight glass, pressure gauge, pigtail, pressure troll, transformer, automatic vent damper, spill switch, blowout switches in there. This is hot. That's hot. That's hot. Let's get our thermal camera out. All right. A good technician is observing their surroundings. Take a look at that. That white streak coming from the top of the water heater. Not there. Not there, but this 40 gallon is leaking. Let the homeowner know. Okay. So this install 9 years ago, I'm gonna call it the deficiencies. No drip leg on the 15 PSI relief valve. And I did not do a drop header. Other than that, there's nothing wrong with this install. And we didn't do a combustion test, but now we did. Keeping it real.